Yeah, hello everybody. This is Brother Kingsley. Today I want to talk about virgin. Are you a virgin? You see, because me and you should be what? Should we be virgin in the eyes of God? You see, the Bible says in the book of John 17, verse 17, it says, satisfy them in the truth. Or your word is the truth. That means the word of God is truth. You see? So if God is truth, guess what? Through this word have set me and you free from being contaminated by the word. You see, we are children of God. We are virgin. We are special virgins in the eyes of God. You see, we are not to walk by the feelings of this world. You see, we are walked by the word of the truth. You see, just as the book of John 16, verse 13 says, when the Spirit of truth comes, he will guide you into all truth. You see, all truth, that means also in my marriage, you see, in my life, because the Holy Spirit is what is the guide. And the question is this, are you willing to listen to the Holy Spirit today? You see, because that's the key point. If you are willing to listen to the Holy Spirit, it's going to guide you in all truth, you see. Listen, people, we know that we are specially married to Jesus Christ, just as Jesus Christ is the church, you see. And all of us, male and female, we are specially married to him, you see. Apostle Paul said the same thing in 2 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 2. He said, for I feel a divine jealousy for you, since I bestow you to one husband, mean he's giving me and you to one husband. Who is the husband? Jesus Christ. To present you as what? As a pure virgin to Christ. But he said, verse 3, he said, but I am afraid that a serpent, means the devil, have deceived Eve by cunning, your thought will be led astray from a sincere and pure devotion to Christ. So what Apostle Paul is saying here is this, because the devil is very cunning, he has moved a lot of people away from the devotion to one husband, me, Jesus Christ, you see? And that is what Apostle Paul is saying. So put it in this way, you know, like in the Jewish tradition, when a man and woman, they get together, they bestow each other, guess what happens? They have 1 year. In within that 1 year, guess who is the best man? The Holy Spirit is the best man. You see, the Holy Spirit is there to make sure there's no any foul play. You see, to make sure that the woman is kept pure, make sure the man is kept pure. You see, make sure there's no anything evil going to take place until they are united together as what? As husband and wife. And the same way today, Holy Spirit is separating me and you from sin, from evil, from this wicked, adulterous generation, from this vile society, from this ungodly society, to make sure that me and you live a holy life. Because what? We are engaged already to one man, and that Jesus Christ, you see. So this idea about boyfriend and girlfriend, show me where it is in the Bible. You shouldn't be doing that. You see, you should be what? Be a virgin. I am a virgin. You are a virgin. If you give your life to Christ today, you don't need to have any side chick. You don't need to have any man by the side, you see. Because you have one lover, you don't need to have another lover on the side, you see. And that is why when I start this message, I say, are you a virgin? Because if you're not, you should be. I'm talking about spiritual virgin because we are married to Jesus Christ. So that means we are married to him. We don't have another person aside, you see. And that is why the book of Jude is very important. Jude 24 says, now to him who is able to keep you from stumbling, meaning the Holy Spirit is able to keep me and you from what? From sins, and to do what? To present us blameless before the presence of his holy God. Amen. And that is why I'm here today to tell you, as a child of God, don't do boyfriend, don't do girlfriend. You see, if you are telling me that you are following Jesus Christ, that means you are following one person, isn't it? Why do you want to have somebody else on the side? You see, and get this wisdom today, because the word of God is plain and loud and simple for me, and it should be the same for you. You see, the word of God is truth. We don't walk by sight, we walk by faith, we don't walk by feelings, we walk through the truth which is in the word of God. And that is why the book of John is very important. Just Christ said, why you call me Lord, Lord, and you don't keep my commandment? When you call somebody Lord, so that means, guess what? You have to obey the person, he owns you. Is you have to listen to his command. And that's why Jesus Christ said, on that day, many will come. Lord, I did this in your name. He's going to say to them, well, depart from you iniquities. You iniquities, you workers of iniquity, get behind me. You see? And that is why I'm here to tell you, you are a virgin. I am a virgin. Amen. In Christ Jesus Christ, we are married to one husband. And that husband is who? Jesus Christ. Amen. Remain blessed in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. God bless you. Bye.